The hardest part about being a content creator is honestly the crazy interesting things that you pick up for your channel. Now featuring 50% more waifu. That's right. Look at like how big this is. Pick this up for 22 on the internet saying, oh, it's so beautiful. Yeah. So now for Waifu Wednesdays, we now have 50% more animu. God, I can't wait to see what we're gonna do with this. Screw Majin Buu, you're being cheated on. Alright guys, you ready for Blue Robbie's? No, it won't be Blue Robbie. It'll be a mystery shirt. Can you guess which one goes with the crazy rem? By the way, this is my inner spirit animal. Alright, let's dig into the Narca Watch. Shall we, duelist? All right, it's Friday. We've done it. And you're probably wondering, what is on your screen? Well, this is the newest form in my ultimate struggle to become Rainbow Robbie. The greatest of all the Rainbow Robbies. The greatest, whatever conquest that we're fighting for. But I promised White Robbie would appear, and thanks to the help of the patrons, he is here. This is, without a doubt, almost my final form. Yeah, we're not even close yet. And also, special thanks to one of the stream viewers from John and Mine stream. Someone was nice enough. It's the one duelist that always is like, "Ooh, Waifu Wednesdays." We did it. As you guys saw at the beginning of the video, we got the chance to see the newest of the waifus. And she'll probably be making some guest appearances, much like Majin Buu does. I mean, Buu tends to show up, a lot. Every once in a while. And no one's found him yet in a while. So guys, come on, Blue Shirt Squad. Just because I'm white today doesn't mean that I'm not blue on the inside. Boobity bobbity bibbity boo. You know, all Oompa Loompas start off in some shape or form. And unfortunately, this is where I started. So once again, patrons, thank you guys. Dice are ordered. Some other stuff that's going out. Probably be early December, unless something goes quicker. I laughed because there was one guy that signed up Patreon because he's like, "Oh, I haven't gotten what I was promised yet." And I was like, "Hey, what do you mean? Like, I told you guys to be patient and we'll get to it." But yeah, if you're wondering what I'm doing, there's a nice little like patch of just like red up here from like earlier, and I'm just like, we can't have White Robbie be like the most demonic of the Robbies, but these personalities tend to develop themselves, so we'll see how it goes. Wonder what happens if White Robbie and Black Shirt Robbie get into a fight. Who knows? God, it's so adorable. Yeah. Wish I had an actual girlfriend. Sad face. All right. What's going on this week in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Market Watch? I actually discovered that TP8 Feather Dusters are whoop wob wob weeb wob. Near min is 345 on TCG Player. That is ridiculous for what this card is. Sure, it's some alternate art, but like, light plays coming in at 215. Do this guy a favor. If you want this LP, buy it. Do yourself. But I don't know why you'd want to spend that much on a Feather Duster when you can just buy these down here. But TP cards are, they're getting ridiculous. This is a whole new land. Okay, so other stuff in this that's ridiculous. Garma Sword is $175. Why? Dunamis used to be 80. This thing fell. Like, this was like the low point in the set, and this was like lower. But like, these things are 175 now. Like, this is getting ridiculous. This vintage market crap needs to stop. Stupid Slate Warriors from TP8 are $38. Who knew? And then, of course, Magical Arm Shield is fucking 50. And then, meanwhile, this thing's like $3. It's interesting. And then the stupid ritual for Garma Sword is 99. Like, you guys always think, like, we're joking about this. And then, like, you go over here, you're like, ooh, what's Fortress Whale at? Oh, no. Also helps when we spell Fortress Whale correctly. Fortress Whale in and himself. Like, look at this. $200 for light play, $210 for near mint. Oh, my God. And, like, the ritual is, like, nothing. Like, ooh, 35 cents. God, just for a stupid holo. All right. Morphing jars, $424.99 for light play. We did it. It's going to be one of these things I'm not going to understand. And then meanwhile, regular jars are sitting at $55 for near mint. Ugh. Toon tables, still sitting at $65. Literally, it's $65 and $73. You won't even be able to get a set for super cheap. Like, let's be real here. If you want a set, you got to buy the $65, the $71, and the $74.66. No thank you. Grinder Golems, you guys told me to profile this all last week. Look at this. This card isn't good in the TCG yet. I watched someone go Link Spider off the tokens into Akashic, bounce it back to the hand. I was not very impressed by like what the combo was trying to do. So it's definitely something that you should consider. Like, I understand that these are high and I understand that it has the potential, but like, much like Gofu, if the TCG sees this as an issue, I mean, they might preemptively hit it. I mean, we had Gofu for a short amount of time, and it was only after it started becoming an issue that like the card started picking up off the ground. Alright, structure deck. What's going on over here? Trigates are still $2. D-Barriers are $1.94. Cosmics are $2. If you want your common staples, probably should pick them up. Globulb's 39 cents. This guy has 146 copies if you want to just pick them up. Soul Charges, it's a lot of them. Jester Confit's coming in at 34 cents. And just a lot of good cheap stuff over here. Evenly Matches are, damn, they're under 60 now. You can pick up one right now for 57. Boralode's calmed down. They're back under 30. Double Helix is showing himself right out the front door at 1440 or 1475. Continuing on down, I mean, he's got the special edition ticking down here. Akashic Magician's 1173. Hollow, $2. And Vendrick Chimera still holding. He's doing his best. He's still $8. Squib Draws are dropping. This sets, and like, there's still value here, but like, once this. Oh. Yay, as Metaphys, these things are just going to keep dropping. Baguska, of course, Altergeist, Rockets, and like, these dropped. These were holding straight $2, but a few people listed them up. You can get them much cheaper now. Apprentice Illusion Magician went back up. She's not 10 anymore. Yeah, she's going back up to 12. You do you, girl. 419 on Dark Magician Night. This guy's always been money. 323. Where did these go? Does somebody know something I don't? Like, that's a lot of them missing off the market when there's 21 of these. Huh. That's interesting. Souls, still floating the same. Circles, $1.70s. Navvies, Alliance is still nothing. How much going on over here? Redis Baby Dragon, still holding 15. Swords, still holding 12. Gearbreeds went down a little bit. They're 9s. And then we have Red Eye Slash Dragons at 9s. Not too bad. Like, this set gets more and more interesting. Did you know that you can Obedience Schooled out Amazon's Baby Tiger? Cyber Dark Inferno. Speaking of Obedience Schooled, what are these things going for now? 85 cents. I heard a few people talking about wanting to pick these up. This might be something, like, on the more fun side of things. Lullaby. What are you doing, Lullaby of Obedience? I bet these went down because Spirals got hit. 460 on these. It's not bad. Not bad at all. I'm not too disappointed in that. Megatons, Desires, 245s. Still holding. That's not a lot of these on the market, actually. Proxies are holding at 97 cents. Ooh, these are starting to go up. These aren't 35 cents anymore. Actually, that's very interesting. I knew it was going to happen after a little while. And still 4 cents on 68. LOL. Ghost Reapers still coming in at $8. I believe these are still sitting where they were. Cosmics, 6s. D-Barriers, 6s. Foolish Barrel Goods still sitting at 4. Not bad. What's going on in Spirals this week? At what price has Super Agent finally dropped to? $12. Yeah, he's fluctuating between 10 to 11. I mean, he's going to keep doing this for a little while until people. Once we get into regional season, it's my extra drop. Yeah, the deck's very fragile, but like, I was the only one playing Spirals of Locals today. And like, yeah, I went 3-2, but, I mean, I only lost because my friend playing 60 cards ended up opening up Evenly Matched 2 games in a row, and he was main decking it. Like, what are you supposed to do about that? You know, sure, you can make Trigate, but, I mean, your most optimal field is like, oh boy, Kaiju's in the main, too. Like, ugh. Stupid Yu-Gi-Oh! Quick fix, $1.49, LOL. Firewalls went back up. This card doesn't know what the hell it wants to do. It's like a drunkard. 42 now. Tricks to Reincarnations are still at 18s. Knowledges are still at 14s. Ningristus are still at 9s. What is going on? Stop buying these. Don't. It's not worth it. Lumina, Twilight Sworn Generals are 3s. Ugh. Should pick up those Unlimiteds. Gaia Sabers are going to continue to drop. We'll come back to Strike later. Vendread Reorigin still 4. Tricksters still kind of floating in where they were. I mean, and these, back to the fronts, are still $1.20s. Wisdom Eyes are going up $4. Performer Pal Pendulum Sorcerer's coming in at $3. What is life? Ah, good times. Ash Blossoms are $76. These things went back up further. What is going on? Why? Just stop. If Evenly Matched can go back down, why can't we just have cheap Ash Blossoms? I don't get it. Dragon Diagrams are 22s. If you want to pick up this stuff, you probably should do it now. Tornado Dragons calmed down a little bit. They're back down to... Actually, no, these things went up even further. Stupid shipping fooling me. $14 in Tornado Dragons. He's going to keep going up. He's just going to keep doing his best. Duelist Alliance is 7. Unendings are 6. Yeah, nothing else has changed. And actually, Zark went up $1. Huh. Zark is $6 now. Solemn Scoldings. 11s across the board. Yup, this is stupid. I mean, we're in a format now to where you're like, you have to consider playing this because you don't want to lose to Evenly Matched. And it sucks to have to main deck bad cards. But at least, you know, sure, you buy this one and it goes up to 16. You buy this one at 12 and, you know, it goes up to 14. I don't understand it. Dark Magician of Chaos. These things are still a good solid $5. Yeah, there's a lot of mod plays, but I mean, look at the number of these that are actually on the market from IOC. I'm pretty sure a lot of them are light play, but all across the board, like, it's a very solid card. Mattoshea still holding. I've talked about this a few times with the addition of new support coming out. You might want to consider making sure you have your Mattoshea stuff. I believe these went up slightly from what they were. But nonetheless, they're still sitting at this. Tiramisu Ultimate Rares are $6. And that's for unlimited light play. Still seems on these. You might want to consider getting this Chocolat a la mode. Still is $4. I mean, this deck hasn't gotten any support in a while, but like, it's still doing its best. AP07 Pudding Susses are dollars. What is life? All right, Mermel Stub. Megalos coming in at 26s for unlimited. 30s for the light play first aid. Stooses are 2 for 10s. It's like 14. Regular Megalos are crap all across the board. Abyss Lindays, these things are $5 on ultimates. Clown Girls are 11 or $4. Jesus, reading is hard. $3 on these. I don't think there's anything else too special going on over here in Mermel Land. oh, Thor, 60 cents. God, got him. Gammas are sitting at 21s at the moment. They've stabilized for the time being. Ultimate Maxis keep crashing down. They're not 75, they're 66 at the moment. It's a $9 drop. Secrets coming in at 10s. And regular holos are like $8. Huh. Is the common is $7? Wow. All right. Invocations holding at 28s. Macabre's holding at 27s. Yeah, still... Still right where they are. Kraken has overtaken. I repeat, Kraken has re-overtaken his position in the money hierarchy. You do you, baby. You do you. I'm rooting for you. Someday you'll be more than just what you are. I have faith in you, Kraken. You might look derpy, but like, you're my hero. Black Sonics are $4. I bet you guys didn't know that. Hummingbird Ultimates, $7 for Near Mint. This is one of those, why though? Why though? Why are these so much? $7! No. Stupid Grandmargs. Do you guys know the ultimate Grandmargs? Like, all the old Monarchs are worth a little bit, but like, this is pretty stupid. $6 for light play. Grandmarg. When this card attributes summoned successfully, destroy one face down card on the field. No thank you. Ghost Ogre, ultimates are holding at 57. 23 still. Nothing's really changed back here. Actually, yes, this did change. These supers are now 11s. Yeah, they're holding very, very nicely, actually. That's pretty ridiculous. Next up, Ghost Reapers, basically 8 to 9 across the board. Shadal stuff still holding. Actually, these are going up slowly. I believe these were 5 and change last week. This is the last one. I was watching this because, you know, we've been talking about Link Reigns pack, you know. If Shadal's get something in there, woohoo, you know, like, this has to go up. No reason for it not to. Regular D barriers for $5. Get your commons for $1 or $2. Get your hollows for sixes. God. X-Saber stuff just to check in here. Still sitting at 8s. Gotham's. Ultimate Dark Souls still sitting at 4s. Fault Trolls. But Robbie, why are we looking at X-Saber stuff? Because slight movements, little red lights that are telling me we should probably pick these things up just to be safe. Alright. Six Samurai stuff. Unite's calmed down there at 35s. Deck's probably going to flop here. Shians are 16s for ultimates. Kizans are 6s. Cynicisms are holding at 4s. Kage Mushas are at 4s. And for some reason, Cunnings are holding at 8s. I don't get it either. Commandants, light play is $12. You want to pick these up because Necro Valley, now's your chance. Speaking of Necro Valley, how much are ultimate Necro Valleys? I'm actually curious now. Ooh, $18. All right, I'll take it. Phoenix or Clustians are 7s. Yeah, that's about where they were. Dark Paladins. Your most expensive Dark Paladin is this guy, coming in at $11. The rest of them are just kind of floating. You know, there's one of these that was a misprint. It's probably not even on here. It's probably super expensive. I remember which art it is. Digestor Emeralds. You can get stupid. Oh, wow. Someone came through and ate these up. Someone said that we can't let these be cheap on the market. Yeah, someone ate them up. We still got Emeralds chilling at 8s, 7s, and 7s. Grand Soils are $4. Why are you holding value, buddy? Just time to walk away. You're banned now. Errands. My friend was always like buying these out like a long time ago, just to have like a collection of these. Light play $7. Jesus, the memories. It's like the worst light swarm. Yang Zings are super cheap. Now, if you want to move on this deck, like, now's your chance because Dang Long got banned. Just good support. System Down ultimates are still holding very high. What are these things? $12. Unlimited 12. What's a firsty around here? First Ed is, I place 20 for first. I'll take it. Ultimate Judgment Dragons are expensive. $76 on Light Play Judgment Dragon Ultimates. And then just 28 on the Secrets. Tomb Kingdom is literally still $30 forever. Like, that card's never going to change. Beals is sitting at 35. Necroz still holding where they've been. 25s on Valks. Trishula's at 15s. Bryonyx at 13s. Do you guys know that Melty Yells, the secret, is sitting at $20? This is pretty stupid. Not gonna lie. Like, but why though? I mean, just because I can destroy a card on the field? I mean, doesn't even seem that good, but I guess I'll take it. Gateway to Chaos has gone up even more, even though set rotation is gone. For some reason, this stupid thing is holding its value. Like, I am not going to understand this. This is stupid. $15. Rome Mages, actually. Do you guys know these things are $14? And then these are $3? Someone, if you want to have some fun stuff here, as a fun deck, $14. Our Left Arms are still going up slightly. Back up on the train here. $14. What else is going on back here? Solemn Strikes, Ultimate Strikes are down. You can pick up one light play for 49. 10s on Secrets, 8s on Shitty Reprints. Supers are at 6s. Things are going to keep going up too, I think. Apex Avions, man. You guys remember when these things were expensive? You might want to, I don't know, if you want a set of these, $10 isn't bad. DTs are 15s. Ooh, Retro Pack Ring of Destructions. There are none of these on the market except for a very heavy played one, which Robbie no recommend. And then you've got the one from Sin City Yu-Gi-Oh! For $50 for near mint. And then you can just play an ultimate for $11. I'd consider that the We Did It 25-cent Ring of Destruction. Alright, guys, we're going to take a quick look at for so well. And I do want to start here at Ancient Knights. This is, I believe, the current set, the latest block. A few people are like, oh, what's the random thing Robbie's going to talk about this week? Stupid Uber is. I don't even know what these things look like. This is actually pretty cool. Like, I'm a huge fan of, like, Ubers and things like that. Freyala, actually, her regular form looks better than the Uber. You pretty much just got Ubers here. This card looks so weird to me. Fathra's Escort, full art. I wonder if that card's actually good. What's her face is full art, though, is gorgeous. Look at this. Fiala the Revolutionist. Like, what is this? Like, I love the anime concepts that this game does. But, like, $12 isn't bad for that. Full art concepts. This doesn't look like it belongs here. Vampire? What did Force of the Will do? Millium Successor of the Future? Alternate full art? Huh, so this game just has alternate full arts now? I kind of missed a block. Dark Riding Hood. That's actually really cool. I love that art. Little Tyrannosaurus Rex. So it's got a lot of good $4 cards in it, but I assume that this is only for the full arts, right? Oh, for the White Mist. Huh. That looks cool as well. I'm just here for the cool things. Dolphins. Furious Command. Alright, so you guys think this is ridiculous. Force of Will actually does have promos. The Legendary Grimm from Indonesia is 150. Reflect Refrain, the Judge promo, 144. The Broken Prissia, Friend of the Animals. The one that was actually really, really, I believe this thing was causing a lot of problems in the game. It was from like a redemption or something. You can't release a tier 1 card as redemption and not expect there to be repercussions. Uber Prissia, if you want a cool token, is $14. It actually looks really nice. I recommend it. Outside of that, I mean, the old Ubers, I kept my Cybill. Yeah, Sylvia, the Lancelot, the Knight of the Mad Toilet. He looks like he's constipated AF. I mean, this is pretty much just the old stuff that's been holding value here. Full art Scyther are $8. Jesus. And Gil is $11. I think this is just people trying to move a lot of the older promos just to get rid of them. This one's a new one. Hymiel's Memoria. Yeah, $8. All those old expensive Ubers that are doing nothing now. People are, like, if you want to pick up, like, a nice old out-of-date deck, like, I don't think these are going to go down that booty, though, for tokens. Does that say Skittles? Oh, Skirtless. Why did I read Skittles? Black Moonbeam. Yep. What do you guys think of Force of Will? I love it for, like, the token factor. Like, it's always so cool. Split Heaven and Earth got, like, the best alternate art. Like, if you used to play this game, this card was broken. This art is so awesome. I just don't understand, like, why they print promos of cards that are out of print. It's a new one to me. Oh, yeah, the Caster Firestones. Yeah, Cybill. Baby, we did it. I actually get to play the old fun deck. All right, that's all I got for you guys this Market Watch. Patrons, Blue Shirt Squad, everybody, thank you. Means a lot to me, guys. You've been an immense help on this channel, and I honestly hope that everything that I'm trying to do with this channel, you know, we're going to have the 12 Days of Christmas more than likely this year. We'll see how that goes. We'll see what kind of pricing and things we got this year. But a lot of other things to look forward to is we're doing the Market Watch all the time. All right, guys. Deuce Areno, my audience Areno. The ride never ends, guys. Make sure you enable those notifications to get the latest videos that are being posted on this channel. Make sure you guys check out VanCole40 for my Cardfight Vanguard channel. And join me in House of Champions on the Zodiac Duelist TV Twitch stream. I will be interacting with our audiences. And please check out No Limit Gaming, NLGTCG.com, for the cheapest trading cards on the market. Thanks for watching, guys, and please have a good day.